We're back with Levi Johnston and family. And Levi, many of our viewers have something to say to you, and I'm sure you can understand some of them are not happy. Our David Thayall is here with their comments and questions from our blogs. David?
Larry, this is the blog, of course, at CNN.com/LarryKing. The conversation is happening right now. Some of the criticisms that we're hearing from about Levi on the blog tonight aren't his 15 minutes up, we've been asked. Somebody else says, Levi, shame on you for going public with such private matters. Yet another person says, this kind of behavior does nothing to help your little boy. And a question also, Larry, for Levi from the blog. This comes from somebody who asks, wouldn't any time you spend with your child be worth whatever hassles are presented? Says this person, he's a father whose job takes him away from his children, and he says he would give anything to be able to hold them every day.
Levi, would you agree with that?
You know, I don't. I think that it shouldn't be like that. I should be able to, you know, have rights with them, you know, come get them whenever I want. I shouldn't have to, like...
But that's what they're saying, and nothing should have stopped that. In other words, a father would say, you go, you bang on the door. You have a lawyer. You file a summons. You bring her into court, which is what legalities do. And then a judge decides who sees this baby and when. Don't you all agree?
Yeah. I agree
I'm
with
not,
that.
I'm sure anybody would agree with that. The governor would agree with that. You get it resolved in court, I would think. We have a Facebook question for Levi from CNN's Facebook page. It's from Crystal. She wants to know, if the Palins are making it difficult for you to function in your role as Tripp's dad, have you been able to experience any of the joys of fatherhood?
When he was first born, I got to be with him a lot. And, you know, I know I'm missing out on a lot of his life right now. And it's sad. And you know, I'll never get that time back.
How old is he now?
He's about 4 months.
Have you spent time with him, Merced?
Yes, I have. I've spent little time with him, but the time I've had has been wonderful, and I try to endure it and take as many pictures and make sure I have memories with him because I don't know how much time will be left.
An email question from Russell in Wilson, Oklahoma. Levi, I know this is personal, but how much child support do you have to pay each month?
You know, I ain't doing a whole lot, no child support right now until we go to court. I got everything my boy needs back home, diapers, toys, you know, everything. And once we go to court and, you know, deal with that, then, you know.
How do you respond to the other side's claim after the appearance on the previous shows that you're doing this for fame and fortune?
You know, I didn't ask to be thrown into this, so I'm not out here looking for fame. I'm just trying to get my story out there and let the people know what's really going on. And so, you know, I'm not looking to get famous and be a celebrity. That's not what I'm doing.
Sherry, do you have thoughts at all as to why this has happened? All right, they broke up. But why? That would bog my mind.
I think they were doing great. And then when this got thrown out that Levi was dead, the next day we woke up, paparazzi, everything was there. And following him around, everything just got, I mean, it's bad enough being a teen trying to keep a relationship going, then you throw in pregnancy, and that's major. Then you throw in, you know, being followed by media and all the, I mean, just tremendous amounts of on their shoulders where they couldn't think. I mean, they
didn't
have time.
Do you think, Merced, and this would just be a thought, you have no facts,
right,
that the governor is affecting Bristol's treatment of Levi?
I'm not too sure. I can't really answer that. I haven't really been a part of Levi and Bristol's relationship because the distance she put between Levi and I.
Well, the Bristol that you know, Levi, does it shock you that she won't let you be with your son?
No, I think ever since that campaign, she's changed a lot.
Oh, she did?
Yeah, I think so. That wasn't the Bristol I knew before she got pregnant, and you know that wasn't.
How did it go to her head?
That's like the only thing you know you think of. She's totally different now.
Totally different.
In a big way.
There's talk of Levi modeling or even writing a book. Is that a practical plan for making money to maybe support a child? That's next. And the Palins are telling me that now when they go back to Alaska, they intend to take some legal action. and the right to see the boy, right?
The Johnstons?
Yeah. You are going to take legal
That is the step we're going to have to go.
And to be fair here, we have not heard from the Palins on this, and I expect they may dispute Levi's story about visitation issues with his son. And if they wish to contact us, we'll, of course, give equal time. About that modeling and acting and money-making, any truth?
You know, Larry, there's been a lot of people coming and calling and a lot of offers out there for me to do a lot of things. And, you know, nothing's set in stone. I haven't signed or done anything. And, you know, I haven't made a dime off anything I've done yet. So for them to say I'm out for fame, fortune, you know, that's ridiculous.
Suppose someone came to you with an offer to, let's say, model.
You know, then that my guy, Tank Jones, can talk to him about it.
Tank Jones, he's here with you, right? He's your PR guy or a representative?
Yep.
But so far, you haven't made a dime.
No. I haven't made no money yet.
Tank Jones has been there for us, and Rex Butler. We couldn't have done it without them. They have been keeping us strong going through all this with the media.
So, and how did you get him to represent you? Tank.
Well, we needed a lawyer, and we got two.
And they sent Tank to you?
Yes.
Well, Tank's a lawyer.
My lawyer is Rex Butler, and Tank is partnered with him, and they're helping us through everything.
Sherry, in December, shortly before Tripp's birth, you were arrested on drug charges, right? What is the status of that case?
I can't go there right now. When I have my day in court, then I would love to be able to set the record straight. There's a lot of misconception out there, but I can't go any farther than that right now.
Well, you could say, are you innocent of the charges?
If anyone would like to get more information, they could talk to my lawyer, Rex Butler.
And where is he?
And he's in Anchorage, Alaska.
Rex Butler.
Rex Butler.
As soon as the news about Bristol's pregnancy broke, the story became fodder for late-night comedy. Here is a sample.
Thank you, and I must say your brother Stephen is my favorite Baldwin brother. I want to take this opportunity to say, live from New York, it's Saturday night!
The GOP gonna need your vote in the next election. Can I get a what from the senior set? Put your hands up, all the marriage in the hands, put your hands up.
What'd you make of all of that, Levi, when it was going on? It was kind of a weekly thing, and certainly on the nightly shows.
It was different. I don't know what to think about it all.
It was hard?
Yeah. It was distracting, I guess.
Sherry, how'd you take it?
I don't know. Same, I guess.
Goes with the territory? I mean, yeah. Did you come to accept it?
Yeah.
That's your life, Merced. What do you want to do? You want to go to college?
Oh, absolutely. I'm not too sure where yet. I've been looking to a couple of different places for medical school, but...
You want to be a doctor?
I want to become a surgeon.
A surgeon?
Mm-hmm.
So, you haven't been... Will it be in Alaska?
No. I want to go out of state, hopefully.
And you're through with high school, right? Or aren't you?
No, I haven't taken my final test, no.
Are you going to do that?
Yeah.
Well, I thank you both, or all of you, for coming very much. Good luck to you, Levi.
Thank you.
Thank you, Larry. Thanks for having us.
Thank you, Larry.
Thank you, Merced. Levi Johnson, Sherry Johnson, Merced Johnson. Someone took a shot at TV's bounty hunter last night. Dwayne Chapman says the man he was...